Hey guys, welcome to Sunday service. Can you guys believe that it's already the last Sunday of July? Time is going by very, very fast, as it's already been over 4 months since we last saw each other. And I really miss you guys. I really hope and pray that you guys are safe during this whole pandemic. And let's pray. Let's really pray that God will allow us to gather together sooner than later. So can we do that? Let's pray together before we begin our time of worship. Let's pray. God, thank you so much for giving us this opportunity today to worship you. God, honestly, it is difficult to worship you when we are staring at a screen, and we really want to get together to worship you on Sunday mornings in person. But until then, we pray that you'll help us to have the heart of worship as we sing, as we listen. Help us to and lead us during this time of worship where we can truly worship you, where we can truly experience you, and where we can be energized again to live for Jesus. Thank you again. We love you. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, at this time, let's all stand up and get ready for praise. Now, I know some of you guys, although I can't see you guys, I know that you guys are just staring at a screen and you guys are not doing the motions, you guys are not singing. But today, if we can, let's all stand and let's sing as loud as we can as we are giving this praise to God and only God. So let's sing this song together. As we continue in our worship, let's all recite the Apostles' Creed together. Are you guys ready? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Universal Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The word of God today comes from the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verses 3 to 5. Revelation chapter 21, verse 3 to 5. So if you have your Bibles, please take out your Bibles. It's actually the last book of the Bible. So if you want to go all the way to the last book, it's Revelation And it's chapter 21, verse 3 to 5. Are you guys ready? It's a very short passage. Revelation chapter 21, verse 3 to 5. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and the death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain any more, for the former things have passed away." And he who was seated on the throne said, "Behold, I am making all things new." This is God's word. Thanks be to God. Let me pray for us once more. God, as we listen to your word today, help us to focus and help us to really receive your word with an open heart. We pray for all the students and parents who are watching this. May it be the word of God, the truth, the living truth that speaks to us. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Friends, now I know some of you guys love Disney movies. So I know I was a big fan when I was growing up. So let me ask you guys a question. What is your favorite, all-time favorite Disney song? Is it Under the Sea from a movie called Little Mermaid?
Under the sea, under the sea.
Or is it Let It Go from the movie Frozen?
Let it go, let it go.
For me, when I think about favorite Disney songs, one of my all-time favorite has to be from the movie called Aladdin. Has anyone seen that movie before? Aladdin. Now, there's a song in Aladdin that really is awesome. This song. Can anyone guess what song I'm thinking about? It's a song called A Whole New World. I wish I can sing it for you guys, but I know you guys will cringe and I don't want to ruin the song for you guys. So let's listen to that song for a little bit. I'm gonna share with you guys just a part of that song. Let's listen.
A whole new world, a new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
Wow, what an awesome song. What a beautiful song. If you ever watched Aladdin, this is the song that they sing when Aladdin takes Jasmine on a magic carpet ride. Now, let's be real here, guys. Like, we're not Aladdin, we're not Jasmine, and we don't have a flying magic carpet with us. But what we do have is the Bible, the living Word of God. And the Bible tells us today that the God that we worship is inviting us into a whole new world, not on a magic carpet ride, but a whole new world that is better than any Disney movies. Can you imagine that? Look with me in verse 5 of today's passage. Verse 5, it says, "Behold, I am making all things new." I am making all things new. So how is God making all things new, right? How is God making all things new? And what does this new world that God is inviting us look like? And how could it be better than Disney? Because Disney is the best. Because from the look of it right now, right, as we look out the window or as you watch the news, the world that we're living in doesn't seem very good. Well, friends, let me explain. You are right. Friends, you are right when you say that the world that we're living in today is far from perfect. Even though God created the heavens and the earth and made people in his image, as we saw starting from Genesis with Adam and Eve, people didn't listen to God. People disobeyed God. People sinned. And because of that, the relationship between God and people have been damaged, have been broken. Not only was the relationship damaged, but also the world was damaged. We see this with lots of disasters, lots of wars and dangers in the world. And with all this happening right now with the coronavirus pandemic, it feels even dangerous to go outside. Our schools are canceled. Our vacation plans have been canceled. And we can't even have play dates with our friends. Maybe for some of us, this struggle goes a little deeper. Maybe some of us are struggling with this feeling of loneliness, this feeling of insecurity, feeling of being lost, feeling of being sad all the time. All of this and so much more. And the sad reality, friends, is that things don't appear to be getting any better anytime soon. However, as followers of Jesus, we have some good news. Yes, some good news. As I mentioned, Jesus is inviting us to this whole new world. Because of all the sin and evil and brokenness, people were never able to be in a good, loving relationship with God. And as we look in the Old Testament, we see story after story after story after story of people disobeying God. But that doesn't mean that God is going to wipe away as he presses a reset button with a giant flood like he did during Genesis 6 in the story of Noah's Ark. No, he doesn't reset, but he decides to renew. He decides to renew us, to reshape us. Instead of giving up on us because we all fail to listen to him again and again, he does the only thing that is going to save us. He does the only thing that's going to rescue us. What is that? John chapter 3, verse 16, what does that say? Because God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Friends, God didn't give up on us because we disobeyed. God did not give up on us because we sinned. God promises to never give up on us, even though we break his heart over and over and over again. But instead, God sent Jesus to receive all the punishment that we deserve, to receive all the punishment for the sin that you have committed, sin that I have committed, sin that your parents have committed, all of our disobedience. The punishment for all of that is now placed on Jesus. And in return, what do we get? Jesus receives everything that we deserve. And in return, we receive everything that Jesus deserves. Because of Jesus' death on the cross, the once broken relationship is now fixed, as God is now inviting us to this new world in Jesus Christ. Friends, isn't that awesome? Friends, in this new world that God is inviting us to, we see that there will be no more tears. That means no more crying. There'll be no more pain, right? That means no more paper cuts, no more dying, and best of yet, no more sin. It will be a place where we get to spend all the time in the world with God, and we live with him forever and ever and ever. Friends, this is a promise that God is making with us. So then, how do we get there? Or when do we get there? When do we get to enjoy this whole new world? When do we get to live in this world where there is no more crying, where there is no more dying, and where there is no more sin? Well, friends, the honest answer that I can give you is I'm not sure. Only God knows when exactly that is going to happen. But although we don't know when we'll get there, what we do know is that we will get there. If you believe in Jesus, it is a promise that God is making that your future has been decided, that you will end up in this whole new world. But until then, as you know, life here on earth is not going to be easy. You can ask your parents. I'm sorry, friend, but life will only get harder and harder and harder. As we live for Jesus, we will face hardships. If you say that you're a Christian, if you say that you're a follower of Jesus, you're going to face difficulty. Some of us have already experienced that at school. As you shared with me, some of us maybe got bullied at school because you said you're a follower of Jesus. Some people gave you some weird looks at school because you said you go to church on Sunday and they don't. Friends, the person who wrote this book of Revelation is John. If you remember, John, who is one of Jesus' disciples, he wrote this book. And as he kept on sharing about Jesus, even after Jesus died and resurrected, the Roman government didn't like the fact that John kept sharing about Jesus. So what did he do? What did they do? They put him in jail. They put him in jail all the way in this small island called Patmos so that he can never share about Jesus again. But when he was in jail, when he was in prison, he wrote this book as he was given this vision from God, so that more people can learn about this new world that God is inviting us to. Friends, because we follow Jesus and because we believe in Jesus, some people are not going to like us. We might even lose some friends. And for some, like in different parts of the world, they might even lose their lives. I know people who are being threatened because they say they believe in Jesus. But friends, don't let these things discourage you from following Jesus, but instead, let's be encouraged. Those people put their lives on the line and follow Jesus because he's worth it, because he's real, because this whole new world that he's inviting us to is real. So let's not be discouraged, but instead, let's be encouraged. He wants us to live for this new world that God is inviting us to, rather than living only for this world that we're living in today. A new world where there is no more crying, a new world where there is no more sadness, no more pain, and no more sin. And friends, I pray that we will live for this new world. And even when things get hard in life, right? Because things will get hard in life. Let's remember what our good friend Dory taught us. Just keep swimming. Just keep swimming, right? Let's keep on believing in the promises of God. Let's keep on believing in the promises of God. Let's keep on running to Jesus and talking to Jesus every day. Let's keep on living as we prepare for this new world. Amen. Let's pray together. God, I want to thank you so much for giving us this invitation to a whole new world. But Lord, we pray that you'll help us to not be distracted, not be tempted to stop running to you, but to always be faithful to you. God, we confess that situation in life is not easy right now with the coronavirus, with all that's happening in the world, but we do pray that even when difficulties arise, help us to look to you and cling on and hold on to your promises. Thank you, Lord. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, time at this time, let's go into a time of offering. If we can, let's say this prayer together as we give our offerings, or as we give our lives as offering to the Lord. Lord, I give my life as an offering to you. Amen. All right, let's all stand up and let's get ready for our closing praise. And after we're done with the closing praise, we'll close together with the Lord's Prayer. Friends, I dearly miss you guys, and I'm praying for you guys, and I really hope and pray that you guys are praying for each other. So after today's service is over, can we do this? Can we just quickly pray for one friend that is in our church, our one friend that we miss dearly? Maybe we can call them. Maybe we can ask our parents if we can call our friends in church to kind of talk to them. You can call me as well. I'm always open to speaking to you guys, but let's really learn to pray for each other. All right, guys, I hope you guys are doing well, and I will see you guys next week. You Let's close together with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is done in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and glory forever. Amen.